Hey guys, what is up? It is Spooky Noodles. I know it's been a while since I made a video, but well, it's maybe been like 2 or 3 days, but I thought I'd make one today because I went book shopping. So the story about this is that we went up north to the Upper Peninsula, and it was to get a car for my mom's boyfriend, but it was kind of like a forced vacation that became really fun. It was impromptu, but it was a lot of fun. We went to the UP and saw some stuff. We saw Taconima Falls, which is a beautiful waterfall. Maybe I'll put a video in this video of it, like a clip from that trip. I know that I have pictures, but I have one video, so. So we saw the falls, which was really pretty. And then we started headed down south to go back to Ann Arbor, and we stopped along the way in Traverse City. And in Traverse City, there's a bookshop called the Book Vase Bookshop. In there, I found quite a few books, not that many horror per se, but I found some good books. So, without further ado, let's get into it. And I'm sorry about the shakiness of the camera. I'm currently stationed on a air mattress, so it's gonna bob and weave a little bit, so I apologize. So let's get started with the books I got. Alright, we're gonna start with the horror books. Well, not per se, the first one's not a horror book per se, but it's by a legendary horror author, so I like to consider it horror. I have no idea if I'm actually going to read this series or not. I plan on trying to find all the books in paperback format. And, yeah. So the first one is Wastelands by Stephen King. I found this book once at a Salvation Army, and when I picked it up, it just fell into tatters. It was just bad. It was all bad. But this is the third book in the Dark Tower series. It's a big one, as you can see. I picked it up and was like, yeah, that looks like a pretty good copy. It's not the best copy, but it's a pretty good copy. And yeah, this is probably the coolest looking one because it has a train on it or a locomotive of some sort. So yeah. And you can look it up what it's about, but it's the third book in a series, so I'm not going to do that to myself. So yeah. Alright, next, we have The Influence by Ramsey Campbell. Ramsey Campbell is a popular horror author. This is a tour horror. And this has a die cut. It's a pretty cool one, too. I don't know what this is about. I'm not gonna read the synopsis to you. You can look it up if you'd like. This video is going to be too long if I start reading synopses or the synopsis of these books. So, yeah. Alright, let me put all the westerns aside really quickly because I have quite a bit of westerns and then one that I don't know what it is. I think it's a mystery novel, but we'll get to that in a minute here. The first book I have here in the horrors, and that's of course you consider the Wasteland to be a horror book. I have a good copy of Bentley Little's The Town. Spine's never been broken. Other than that, you know, crease right there, it's a pretty good copy. I'm probably going to replace my copy at home with this one, and then maybe I will put it the other one in a giveaway box. But this is a pretty good looking copy, and I'm going to choose which one is the better copy, and then the worst copy will go into the giveaway box. So there you go. Next, we have John Saul's Shadows. Don't know much about this book. I didn't bother to read back because I saw John Saul and I was like, well, kind of collecting John Saul. So I inadvertently am collecting John Saul. So I decided to pick it up. And yeah. All right. Last one is a J.N. Williamson book, and if you know anything about me, I'm collecting J.N. Williamson books. I don't know how you guys feel about the author. I hear mixed opinions about him. He wrote a lot of books, so if I like him, then I found a new author with a huge catalog. You know what I'm saying? If I don't like him, then there's no loss. I can sell his books because they sell for pretty good. That being said, I have this one, which I've never heard of or seen of, or any. I haven't even heard anyone talk about this book, but it's called The Evil One by J.N. Williamson. It has a creepy doll on the front cover. So I'm guessing this is about a evil doll of some sort. And if you don't know me, then let me tell you that in Goosebumps, one of my favorite books was Night of the Living Dummy. That was a really good Goosebumps book. It's not my favorite of all the Goosebumps. My favorite is Say Cheese and Die. I just like the boy finds a camera, or was it a girl? I can't even remember. But this kid finds a camera and takes a picture, and everyone's dead. Or, well, it predicts the future. Anyways, this is The Evil One. I don't know what it's about, other than it's about a doll being possessed. So, yeah. And that's it for the horror. But now we are on to the next one, which is, I think, a mystery novel. I'm not sure. It just says fiction, and it's kind of caught falling apart here. I didn't realize how bad. They had four copies of this book. Now that I'm looking at it, I picked the wrong copy. Because my copy is like falling apart. But this is Tony Hillerman's Skinwalkers. It says best-selling author of Sacred Clowns and A Thief of Time. So this one says full of mystery, intrigue, and dangerous magic by Ross Thomas. And unfortunately, I have the sticker on the description, so I was actually planning on reading this one for you guys. But no, I guess not. This has a lot of Navajo, what's the word I'm looking for? Navajo stories, I guess. Not stories, folklore. Like, because the monster's a skinwalker. So I thought I'd get that for learning's sake. So yeah. All right, next we have Westerns. And boy, did I buy a few. I bought six to be precise. And I think most of these have to do with like guys getting revenge on outlaws. So, without further ado, let's just start with the first one, which is by Frank Rodarus. Rodarus? That's Finding Nevada. I think this is a pretty neat cover. You got the guy looking all stoic in front of these people who are afraid for their lives. Says on the front, when Harrison Wilk inherits a mine, it could mean gold or a passel of trouble. So yeah, it's a small one, by the way. This one clocks in at 151 pages, and I'm into these short reading westerns. I like how short these westerns are. So yeah. All right, next we have a book that I actually have been looking for. And I'm surprised I found this one at the bookstore. But this is The Saga of Denny McCune. And it says on the front, he was just a kid, but he vowed revenge on his father's killers. And you know me. By now you should know me, if you're subscribed, but my westerns, I like westerns if they have to do with like revenge. I don't like ones that demonize Native Americans. So I don't like anything to do with cowboys versus Indians. So I try to stay away from that. But Western's kind of like, that's a big part of Western. So it's like a novelty of Westerns, so, or whatever. But yeah, this is by Bert and Bud Author. And I will in the future have more of these books by Bud and Bert and Bud author. That's kind of a spoiler for an old video in the future, but yeah. Another small one, by the way. This one clocks in at 128 pages. Which is weird because I flipped it and it was like 125 and then went right up to 100. Oh, there we go. Okay, never mind. But yeah, 128 pages. All right, next is The Game of Death by Arthur Moore, author of Rebel. That's a neat cover, by the way. All right. I don't know much about this one. Says for a bounty hunter, murder meant money and sudden death. I'm not gonna read the synopsis because it's a long one, but and I just said I wouldn't read synopsises, but a synopsis of these books. But yeah, neat cover. It has to do with revenge, I believe. So I bought it. This one's a little bigger than the other ones, and the font is kind of small. But it comes in at 171 pages. All right, next we have Wayne D's, which I've heard Wayne D before. It just says he's a two-time Spur Award winner. And this is Overholser, Valley of Guns. And I'm guessing Overholser is a series, I'm guessing. And the book itself is called Valley of Guns. So I'm guessing we're following a guy who this Wayne D wrote a lot about. I'm guessing. And it just says it's like a rebel with a cause, and it has a synopsis. So, yeah. All right, two more left. Oh, and by the way, if you were interested, I think I already said this one. Yeah, I did. 171 pages. This one is clocked in at 92. So they're getting bigger and bigger, y'all. That's what she said. This one's by Phil Dunlap, and it's called Call of the Gun. This is first time in paperback. Actually, I had another one that said first time in paperback as well. I don't know what this one is about other than I'm pretty sure it's about revenge. I'm not sure though. I don't remember. But yeah. And then last, but definitely not least, well, at least I don't think it's least, Elmer Kelton's Eyes of the Hawk. And this one, actually, I read the synopsis and I was like, that actually sounds pretty well. Swell, I mean. This is Elmer Kelton writing as Lee McEllery. Or McElroy, my bad. Who wrote The Man Who Rode Midnight? And there's the cover. You got a guy with a rope, a hemp rope, a revolver in his holster, what do you call it? A bandolier, I think it's called. I forget what that's called, but it usually goes around the chest. Anyways, basically the eyes of the hawk, and he learned some of his trade. As you know, he learned his skills from Native Americans, and the Native, was it Native Americans or Mexicans? I can't remember. But one of the two trained him. No, it had to be Native Americans. The Native, no, it's the Mexicans. I might glanced over and it says Mexicans right there. The Mexicans call him the Hawk because he's brash, violent, and fought ruthlessly. Or something like that. Or no. I'm sorry, I'm stupid. It's because he's a proud man and a fierce-eyed with a fierce-eyed stare. And the Mexicans call him the Hawk. Or Gavilan. Or however you say that. Gavilan? Gavilan? I don't know. I keep saying it the same way, so I'm sorry. But yeah. This is an award-winning Western storyteller, so this has to be good, right? But yeah, this one clocks in at if I can flip the page, oh, flip the other page, 182 pages. So again, I got a lot of small westerns because I like these small westerns because you read them pretty quickly and you get a good revenge story out of it. So that is it. Out of all of them, if I was to say which ones were my favorite, I would probably have to say The Evil One by J.N. Williamson is probably the best find, but The Eyes of the Hawk, the book I just showed you, is probably the favorite Western that I got. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. This has been a quick video. Actually, it hasn't really been quick. It's been 16 minutes long, so I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I hope you guys are having a great day. I know I am. It's been a wild ride, and yeah. So I'm about to get back to normal life soon, and I don't know how that's gonna go, but yeah. Hope you guys have a great day. Hope you have a spooky night. I'll catch you in the next video. Peace out.